I wouldn't call it pressure. I think I'd just more call it a bit more confidence in terms of ourselves and our ability and our competitiveness in this tournament. Obviously, first game up is away to Wales, which I think is going to be a massive game. Played them over the autumn period as well, indoors up at Orium, and had a good win up there. So there's a lot riding in this game, I think. There's no denying that. But yeah, just a lot of confidence can be taken from getting that monkey off our back, as it were. I think coming off the back of the first game against Ireland, it was a bit of an odd place to be in terms of we're so close, but yet still lost in the final minute. So it was a bit of an odd change room. But to get that first win against Wales and obviously then following that up with Italy was massive. And the change room afterwards was an absolute scene. So yeah, we're looking to make this winning a bit more, I would say, it's infectious. You kind of get quite greedy after a while. Like once you've had a taste of it, you're kind of wanting a bit more. So yeah, we're looking to put a good account of ourselves out there again. Obviously, having the girls playing over in France has been massive, and just getting more exposure to rugby out there, and they've really thrived under it and really come back with a new buzz into the squad and lifted the rest of the girls there, and it's been brilliant. And obviously Sarah Law up in Scotland as well, doing the full time up there, she's been brilliant and really knuckled down, and it's just lifting those standards again, and it makes the rest of the squad obviously in turn then lift ours, which has been brilliant. Obviously Shade's been trying different combinations, wanting to get his best players on the pitch in whatever way that may be, and it just shows the versatility that we have within the squad, that we have players who are able and willing to step into different positions and out of their comfort zone and still really thrive at the international level. So yeah, it's been an interesting and exciting pre-season, so we're kind of seeing how it's going to build now. I wouldn't say they've kind of brought any intel back. Well, they've not told me any intel back anyway. But they've just kind of brought a different kind of vibe and a different sort of intensity to training. Over there, they're very, very rugby focused, very rugby orientated in terms of training sessions every day of the week. And it's a couple of hours each session, and it's all hands on ball, all skill work. So them coming back with that has been massive, and it kind of opens our eyes in terms of how other nations are training, how other clubs are training, and it just changes up how we then approach our training as well, to kind of to just keep on top of the ever-changing game that rugby is. We're in camp from Thursday to Sunday, so we had a good 3 days' worth of training, and we've had games in the lead-up to that, obviously, with Wales, Spain, and playing down at Harlequins as well. It has really left us in good stead. A couple of girls have got club games coming up this weekend, so there's still plenty of rugby to be played before we go to Wales on Tuesday. So yeah, I think we're feeling in a very good place right now, and we're just excited to see what's going to happen come minute one next week. Favourite in terms of winning, you've got to obviously look towards your England and France. Obviously they performed very well in the World Cup, and they've got that pedigree going through it. Obviously, having them at home this year is going to be huge for us, and it gives us home advantage through up at Scotstoun as well. You'd say it's probably one of those two, but then again, the Six Nations, it can be so unpredictable. Any team can beat anyone on their day, so it's looking to be an exciting tournament again. So I think, to be honest, retracting what I probably said, it could probably be a number of teams winning it. But there's probably a couple of players from around and about. Lots of the squads, obviously you've got Romain for France, she's been tearing it up in the league over in Lille, and had an absolute breakthrough season last season. She's an exciting player to play against. You'd probably say, I'm trying to think who else is there, in terms of England, have got a number of players obviously playing down there now, playing alongside Katie. She's a fantastic player, and you could learn a lot from her. I think she's really good to play, probably obviously alongside, but play against as well, just kind of see how she controls the game, and obviously from the position that I play in terms of either standoff or centre, it's really interesting to see how she controls and dictates the game. So probably Romain and Katie. Oh, it's been massive, you know, it's an absolute honour and privilege to have been part of the BT Academy, and you know, you can really see the developments that have been made across all the girls that have been part of it. It keeps on growing year on year in terms of stage two players, and obviously with our four stage three players as well, and we've still got our performance development pathway as well, who are picking up the younger age group and getting them in early doors, so that we're getting that player depth and player base as well. And obviously we're trying to latch on the back of how successful it has been for the males as well. You're seeing a number of people go on to do Edinburgh and obviously Scotland Sevens as well. So yeah, it's been fantastic. It's been been an absolute privilege to have the opportunity to have all this extra support for S&C and skills and things. And it's, I think you can see on the pitch, it's really reaping the benefits.